Yeah, welcome again to the online classes. We are solving some numerical problems on three-inch parabolic arches. We dealt few problems with arches with abutments at same level, parabolic arch. Now let us see a problem if support points are at different levels. It is 3-inch parabolic arch only, but if support points are at different levels, here is a problem. A 3-inch parabolic arch having supports at different levels shown in figure. Oh, so far figures were not given. Looking into the problem, our work was to draw a figure carefully, but here figure is given. Carries an UDL of intensity 30 kilonewton per meter over the left portion from left inch to the crown. This, they ask you to determine the horizontal thrust developed, HA and HB. Nothing but reactions we have to find. Find also the bending moment, normal thrust and radial shear developed at a section 15 meter from the left support. Okay, okay. It is defined. Some point, bending moment findings. It was asked to draw bending moment diagram. In such cases, we have to calculate maximum bending moment, etc. But here problem, findings are simple. They ask you to find the bending moment at point D, which is 15 meter from the left hinge. Now it is a 3-inch parabolic arch ACB, but A and B are at different levels. You see, the crown is 5 meter above from the left hinge A. Crown in C is 3 meter above from the right hinge B. That means the difference in level between A and B is H1, that is 5 meter, minus H2, that is 3 meter. There is a difference of 2 meter. We have seen a problem of 3-inch circular arch wherein the radius of one portion was 8 meter, radius of the another portion was 3 meter. We have solved that type of problem wherein in that circular 3-inch arch, I had taken a problem wherein inch A, left inch, was at higher level, inch B was at lower level. But here I am taking an example wherein left inch A is at lower level, B is at higher level. The difference in level is 5 minus 3, that is 2 meter. Now the distance of the crown inch from the left inch is, let it be L1. It is not given. Let the horizontal distance between the crown inch and the right inch is L2. But the total span is given, L, between A and B, horizontal length, 40 meter. From the geometry, simple L1 is equal. L is equal to 2L. Okay, we'll come to that. L will be equal to L1 plus L2. LO is equal, total length should be equal to L1 plus L2. That we know, not this one. And let HA and VA are the horizontal and vertical reaction at the left support A. Let HB and VB are the horizontal and vertical reaction at right hinge B. They ask you to find bending moment at D, normal thrust and radial shear at D, and horizontal thrust developed at HA and HB. Anyhow, we have to find VA and VB also, because for normal thrust determination, it is required. Okay. We have the two equations that we have discussed. If two support points are at different levels, that is, let the horizontal distance between A and C is L1 and between C and B is L2, that I have shown in the figure. We have this equation. L1 is equal to L square root of H1 divided by H1 plus H2. Similarly, for L2 also. Okay, anyone, if you take it, is enough. L is the total length or span of the arch. It is given as 40 meter. H1, it is the rise of the crown from the left hinge, 5 meter. This is H1 again, 5 meter. H2, height of the crown hinge from the right hinge, is 3 meter. H2, if you substitute, L1, if you get, we get 22.54 meter. If you know L1, L2 will be L minus L1, that is 17.46 meter. Simple calculation. Now, after finding L1 and L2 from this L, making use of H1, H2, etc., we will come to the equilibrium conditions. As usual, this arch is in equilibrium. Therefore, we can apply sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0 and sigma m about inch point is equal to 0. Now, this is the arch, this is VA, HA, HB, VB, it is subjected to UDL in the left portion. This is the crony, C, A, HA, VA. They are at different level, that is 3 meter and this is 5 meter, correct? Yeah. Now if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0, as usual, plus HA minus HB is equal to 0, or HA is equal to HB, say H. Sigma Fy is equal to 0 if you apply the UDL intensity is 30 kilonewton per meter. If you apply sigma Fy is equal to 0 plus VA minus 30 into L1, this span, this is L1, this one that just now we found, it is 22.54, that is 22.54. Then, oh shit, no, wait, just a minute. We are applying sigma fy condition, then there is no, yeah. This is not a moment, yeah, correct. 30 into L1, because that UDL is equivalent to point load of magnitude equal to intensity of UDL, that is 30 into the length of the UDL, that is L1. It is 22.54 plus VB is equal to 0. From this, VA plus VB is equal to 676. If you calculate this product, send it to the right side, 0.2. Call this equation number 1. Then applying sigma MA is equal to 0. I take clockwise positive, anti-clockwise negative. About A, if you take HA creates zero moment because perpendicular distance is 0. VA creates zero moment because it is also acting at A. Then UDL, it is this. It is acting down, causing a moment like this clockwise. That is plus. And this UDL is equivalent to a point load, imaginary point load. Of magnitude equal to thirty into length of the UDL, that is L1, acts at a distance L1/2. Therefore, the moment of this equivalent point load is clockwise plus, it is 30 into L1 into its perpendicular distance L1/2. Therefore, coming to here, thirty into L one, twenty-two point five four divided by two is the moment due to UDL. Then HB. See, HB it is acting along this line. That means causing a moment like this. That is like this. It is anti-clockwise. Therefore, minus HP into its distance is this. This is the perpendicular distance. to the line of action from A. It is nothing but 5 minus 3, 2. Are you getting? It is minus HB into 5 minus 3 is the perpendicular distance of HB from A. Then VB, it is creating like this. It is anticlockwise. VB into this distance, it is nothing but full length L. It is given 40 meter. It is creating clockwise. Therefore, as VB into its distance 40 meter equal to 0. Now from this we can write one more equation, or we can conclude one more equation, that is 40 VB this minus 2 HB equals, calculate, 7620.78. This VP creates clockwise movement. It is plus the time about A, VB is anti-clockwise only. That is minus VB into 40. That is 40 VB plus 2 HB is equal to 7620.78. This will be equation number 2. If you see equation number 1, 2 and this, VA, VB or H, 3 unknowns, 2 equation, it is not possible to solve. But we know one more equilibrium condition, that is sigma MC is equal to 0. If you apply sigma MC is equal to 0, which side to consider? It is easy if you consider right side because less number of forces. If you consider right side, only HB and VB are responsible or will cause moment. VB like this causing, it is anticlockwise, minus VB into its distance. Now line of action of VB is here, VB, its perpendicular distance is this. It is nothing but L2, correct? Therefore, it is VB into L2. L2 we found 17.46. 17.46 minus VB into 17.46 Then coming to HBA. HB is acting like this. You see about A, I have written in this green color. It was creating like this moment, anti-clockwise, while taking about A. But now C is hinged. About C we are taking. HB will be acting like this. It is causing a moment of this type now. Because you should treat this as center, try to rotate this line. It is clockwise. Therefore, its distance, it is 3. Because this distance, this, the line of action distance, it is this 3 meter. It is given in the question. C is 3 meter above area. Therefore, it is 3 and is equal to 0. From this, another equation in terms of VB and HB, call this equation number 3. Now, it is your mathematics. Substitute HB as H, here also HB as H, VB and H equation, VB and H equation. By solving 2 and 3, we can get VB. And it is VB. You will get 147.58 kilonewton. If you substitute here in this equation number 1, you get VA as 528.02. In that simple mathematics calculator you can do. And if you substitute VA or VB, VB in this equation number 2 or 3, you will get HA or it is H or it is HB as 858.92. That is equal to HA or it is HB. Now reactions are over. Now here they ask you to find horizontal thrust. Therefore, there is no need to find resultant reaction, that is that we are finding this RA, not required. Answer to your question, read the question carefully. They asked horizontal reactions, HA and HB, that is found. We found VA and VB also. They are required for finding the normal thrust and radial shear at a point. Now, that is about the reactions, that is first part, horizontal thrust. And VA and VB also we found. Now normal thrust and radial shear force developed at a section 15 meter from left support. Now here is slightly difference because two supports at different level. What we have to do? We have to concentrate on this portion, that is A to C. For the geometry purpose, what we have to do is we have to extend this parabola with the same like this to the same level. Forget about this, thinking that this is the half parabola. Another replica of this AC. That means CB dash, we should complete it such that B dash will be in the same level of A. That analogous to the arches of the previous type problem wherein two supports are at same level. That is like this, you see. AC is the left portion of L1 from A to C, we know. And another portion, it is was going like this. But now, the same parabola, symmetrically, if you produce it, okay, let it come to A dash. I told B dash, no problem. This rise is 5 meter. Now it is a symmetrical arch like previous problem. This was L1. This is also become L1. Therefore, total span of the symmetrical arch, symmetrical to this on the other side, will be L dash will be equal to 2L1. That is L1 plus L1. Now they ask you to find at this point D at 15 meter. This reactions HA and VA will not change. That is, the portion left of C may be treated as parabola of span L1. L dash will be 2L1. That is 45.08 meter. Now equation of the parabola we know, because it is a symmetrical arch. That is, y is equal to 4h1. Now I modify the equation of the parabola slightly. In place of it, I write as h1, because here h1 and h2 are there. I am producing this h1 parabola to the other side symmetrically. Therefore, h1, x will not change. This l dash, nothing but this l1 plus l1. That is 2l1 will be the span. That is l dash divided by l dash squared. Now at D, the requirements are there. Therefore, at D, that is x is equal to 15 meter. Let us find y. Y is equal to this equation. 4 into h1 is 5, x is 15, l dash is 2l1. That is 45.08 minus x is 15 divided by 45.08 square, because L1 we know it was 22.54. therefore, double this, 45.08, it is 4.48 meter. This vertical ordinate for point D is 4.44. They ask you to calculate bending moment at this point. Calculate the bending moment at this point by considering right side or left side. We can do it. Whichever the side you consider, UDL is coming into picture. Therefore, let us consider left side. Here arrow mark indicated. The forces which are responsible for the bending moment are HA, VA, and this portion of the UDL up to D only. Because left side of D I am only considering. Therefore, VA, it is trying to bend the beam or arch like this. That is sagging. Therefore, plus VA into 15 meter, the line of action, if you want. I will write separately. This is the imagination produced the same arch. Here VA, vertical it is. Horizontal HA. For point D, I am considering the for ideal only this UDL. It is there here also, but I consider this one only. UDL intensity is 30 kilonewton per meter. This is for 15 meter. Now, about VA, about this point D, that is bending moment at D will be equal to, by considering left side, VD. It is trying to bend the arch like this, VA, not VD. VA is trying to bend the arch like this, upward. It is like this, but it will be like, trying to bend like this. That means it is sagging. Therefore, plus VA into its distance is this 15 meter, because the line of action of VA is here. That is 15 meter. VA into 15. Then HA is here. It is trying to bend the beam arch further like this only, in the same direction of its bending, convexity upward. That means hugging. Therefore, minus H or HA into its distance. This is HA. Its distance is this. Line of action is here. Therefore, perpendicular distance or shortest distance to this line is this. That is YD. YD we found. And it is 4.44. Correct? Then this UDL. UDL is acting down. That means trying to press the arch. Again, it is trying to press arch like this. It is convexity upward. Therefore, hugging. That is minus. Now, UDL is equivalent to an imaginary point load of magnitude equal to intensity of UDL 30 into length of the UDL 15 into its distance. You see, this UDL is equivalent to a point load of magnitude 30 into 15 acts at the mid length. This will be 15 by 2, that is 7.5. Is 7.5 is equal to that VA we know, HA we know. If you calculate bending moment, we get 740 kilonewton per kilonewton meter. That is the bending moment point D, which is at the distance of 15 meter from the left inch. Now next is to calculate the normal thrust and radial shear at the same point D. Now to find the normal thrust and radial shear, again you have to draw free body diagram at D.
That is,
this is D. This is A. HA and VA. No ear. Unbalanced force. VD and HD. No. This normal reaction, sorry, normal thrust will act here along the axis of the arch and radial shear FD. Let its inclination is theta. It is almost tangent to the parabola. In addition, there will be UDL. For this length, that is 30 kilonewton per meter. Now, this YD, we know the equation. YD will be equal to 4H1X into L dash, that is L1 plus L1 minus X, divided by L dash squared. To find theta, substitute, that is differentiating dyd divided by dx. 4 into h1 is 5. X, if you take inside, it is L dash only. L dash X differentiation is L dash minus 2X, X square differentiation divided by L dash square is nothing but tan theta. Here, L dash is 45.08 and X is 15 meter. Substitute this here, we get tan theta as summation, and theta will be tan inverse of that. It is 8.44 degrees. Now for the equilibrium. If you apply sigma fx is equal to 0, HD will be equal to HA, that we know. And if you apply sigma fy is equal to 0, VA, that is plus upward, minus VD, minus 30 into 15 meter is equal to 0. Get here BD is equal to 78.62 and H is 858.92. Do you understand? To find the normal thrust here, we have to draw the free body diagram from the point A to D. If you draw free body diagram, this HD and VD are the unbalanced forces. To keep this in equilibrium, they will develop, and this can be found by applying equilibrium condition by considering equilibrium portion of the arch between A to D. That is this. Now normal thrust and radial shear at D can be calculated as like the same analysis, that is ND is equal to VD sin theta plus HD cos theta by resolving, that is ND cos theta, normal thrust will be HD cos theta and VD sin theta in the same direction. Both are plus. That is what it is shown here. You will get 861.25 kilonewton. Then to find FD, it is VD cos theta, because this is theta. Yes, this is theta towards theta. VD cos theta, it is in the direction of FD, therefore positive. HD, if you resolve along FD, it is HD sin theta minus. It is in the opposite direction of FD. That's what it is shown in this calculation. HD sin theta. It is 48.30 kilonewton. That means assumed direction of FD is wrong. It is acting in this direction, opposite direction. These are the findings for this problem. Only you have to imagine like this extended, and you have to consider that arch. Even same thing can be done if findings are required on the right hand side by extending this arch, that means B2, like this B. In that case, span will become 2 times L2. Same thing. That is about the numerical problems in this arches. We have dealt arches, a little bit theory, how the arch will be, when it will be used, different classification of arches, mainly forces acting on the arches. We deal only statically determinate arches. Arches are determinate only if they have 3 hinges. We deal only circular and parabolic 3-hinged arches. We dealt geometry of the circular arch. These are required to know the geometry of the arch. That is to find for findings or for the analysis. This is only geometry. Just remember this formula. It does not give much importance for this, because you have studied all these things in your lower classes. Remember these formulas. Then, 3-hinged analysis, 3-hinged arches. Here we have to remember important equation of the parabola that we know. Only if two support hinges are at different levels, then for some geometries, we require these two equations we have to remember. Now, analysis of 3-hinged arches. Analysis means here we will be finding the support reactions, that is developed at hinges, HEAVA at A, HBVB at B. And if required, resultant reaction at ARA and resultant reaction at RB. Now the second is finding the normal thrust and radial shear at any point in the arch. To do that, you have to deal the free body diagram between one side of the hinge up to that point. If it is in the left portion, you consider left side free body diagram. Unbalanced forces to resist this are to draw free body diagram. HB, H at this point and V at this point will develop. Normal thrust is the force which is acting here along the axis of the arch. And radial shear is the force which acts normal to the normal thrust. And to find these things, by resolving V and H along N and along F, it can be found, that is here. Now, the third analysis here is finding the bending moment. The first bending moment diagram of the beam will be drawn, that is HY diagram here, with ordinate equal to horizontal reaction into height of the parabola. That will become the like zero axis. Then the beam moment is superimposed on this. For beam moment, as usual, if two point loads are acting, you will get a trapezium like this. If there is no loading, a diagram. And if there is UDL, a parabola over the arch parabola, like that. You can deal that in some numerical problem. These are the three findings: support reactions, normal thrust and radial shear at any point, and calculating the bending moment diagram. Then we dealt two problems on circular arch with two supports at the same level and if two supports at different levels. Then we have taken some numerical problems on the parabolic arch with 3 hinges only. Two at the same level, two support points at the same level, subjected to UDL. And subjected to a point load and UDL. And subjected to only point load. And subjected to only UDL, but at different levels. This is another typical problem we dealt now. Okay, now that is about the arches. If you find some more typical problem from the university question paper, you can refer. And with these guidelines, try to solve those numerical problem that is about arches. Because very simple, very easy chapter, definitely compared to any other topics here in this structural analysis. Little thinking is required. Should do carefully. Now, in the next class, I will take cables. We will see what these cables are, how to analyze, when to use cable, what are the different types of cables, etc. in the next hour. Okay, thank you.